So, you're awake. Let's keep this nice and simple. You're going to tell me the code for that purifier, and you're going to tell me now. Technically, your father killed himself. His loyalties lay with the wrong people, and he paid the price. You, on the other hand, have an opportunity to learn from his mistakes. I'll be honest. I'm running out of patience here, and I'm not looking to play games with you. You tell me that code, or it's going to cost you. Why do you insist on provoking me? Tell me the code now.
Colonel, I have need of you.
Mr. President, I have no time for other matters. I'll be with you shortly.
Now, Colonel.
Yes, sir.
I do apologize for Colonel Autumn's attitude. He's been under a great deal of stress lately. I've no doubt that you know who I am. I'm sure you've heard my radio broadcasts. I'd like to have a word with you face to face. I think there are a few things that you and I should discuss. You'll find your possessions in the locker near the door. I'll unlock the way for you. And I'll unlock your restraints as well. I'll be waiting for you in my office. Please don't tarry.
Hold it right there. You're supposed to be in that holding cell. You're not going anywhere. There's a full complement of guards in the next room. As soon as I get them, you're going back to your cell. In a body bag, if necessary. I have somewhere else to be. I'm hit!
They're not who they say they are. Get out while you can, before they get you too.
Please do not impede her progress. Thank you.
Thank you.
You'll never get here at this rate.
Attention, this is Colonel Autumn. You are hereby ordered to ignore the President's previous directive. The prisoner from Vault 101 is to be shot on sight. I repeat, shot on sight. This is an order.
Thank you.
make it. The trip was not what I had intended, but serves as an adequate test of your abilities. Ah, but I have. I'm right here before you. A very open-minded of you. Kudos for embracing the reality of the situation, rather than railing against it. Let's get to brass tack, shall we? There are some things I'd like to talk to you about. Our nation's capital is at a crossroads. The path that you and I choose here today will affect us all. I need you to act on my behalf to ensure that our country's future is secured. My abilities to influence the world are limited at this time. I alone can only do so much. You, however, may come and go as you please. You have a greater degree of freedom. Perhaps it's best if I explain why things need to change, and why I'd like you to act on my behalf. Yes, indeed. The point is that we are hampered at every turn by a world gone wrong. So-called super mutants, ghouls, horrific creatures. The mutations outside these walls must be cleansed before we can prosper. Mutation must be eradicated. I believe your father's work can do that more quickly and efficiently than ever possible before. You must understand. We need to clear the way for humanity to rebuild the wastes. By making a few small modifications to the purifier your father worked on, mutations can be eradicated with a little effort. Anything mutated that comes into contact with that water will be eliminated, removed from the gene pool. The men and women of the world will no longer share it with the horrors and monstrosities that have become so commonplace. In front of you will be a vial of modified FEV virus. It can be inserted into the control console for the purifier. Doing so will inject it into the water supply, and the purifier will take care of the rest. You just need the code to activate the purifier. Simple, isn't it? I find that unfortunate and most disappointing. I must impress upon you the severity of the situation. I cannot allow you to leave unless the vial is in your possession. And why would I do that, when I'm clearly the best hope for the people of the wasteland? What alternative would you suggest? Without the Enclave, what will the world do? Yes, I suppose it is. Very well. You shall have your wish. Once you've left, I'll put an end to the Enclave. I cannot stop Colonel Auden, however. That much will be up to you. I suppose, then, that this is goodbye. You'll have to see yourself out. I have preparations to make.
place! that's over. Well, that's over.
Evening.
Yes? I hope you brought me some cool stuff.
Mad City's latest visitor.
The longer we sit here, the more time they have to shore up their defenses. We should hit them sooner rather than later.
We barely have the manpower to keep the citadel fortified. We've been over this before, Sarah.
So we just wait until they decide we're next on the list? If the Pride goes in now, we might have a chance.
And if you fail, then what? The risk is not worth the reward.
I agree. Without the Gek, the Purifier is useless to the Enclave anyway. They may give up before long.
I don't like it.
You don't have to like it, Sarah. You just have to follow orders.
Yes, Father.
So, you're back. We had feared both you and the Gek were lost. Were you successful?
You were? And yet you stand here before me? I find this hard to believe. What has happened? Then we must go at once. If you have any other information, tell me now before we mobilize. Any help you can give might save lives. Is it now?
That's an unexpected but welcome surprise. Hopefully it'll reduce their ability to defend themselves.
With that in mind, we need to revise our strategy.
If the Enclave has the Gek, there's nothing stopping them from starting the Purifier. They'll figure out the code eventually.
I'm afraid you're right. We need to act now while we can.
Send the Pride in. We can do it. We can win this.
All right, Sarah. The Pride goes in. But I want them to have some extra firepower. Rothschild, is it ready?
What? No, I mean, Lee and I have solved the power problems, but we've only barely finished diagnostic tests.
So?
It's not ready for field tests, let alone live fire situations. The weapons haven't been calibrated, the navigation detection system is offline.
Rothschild, enough. Can you make it work?
Honestly? I don't know. I think we can scrape by, and I suppose if we can't, it won't matter in the long run anyway.
Then it's decided. Sarah, you take the Pride and use the robot as support. Take our friend here and secure that purifier.
Yes, sir. Before we get started, I wanted to let you know that my father and I have been talking. The Pride and I have decided that after all you've survived, you've done enough to be an honorary member of Lion's Pride. So congratulations. Membership comes with some privileges, including our power armor. You want the full suit or the recon armor? Sure thing. Hopefully, it'll give you a bit of an extra edge. Okay. So do you think you can hold it together for this? Now that's what I like to hear, soldier. You all packed? We're not coming back here anytime soon. Okay, don't be nervous. You'll have the whole Pride backing you up, not to mention this giant tin can. Just stay safe until we reach the purifier. You're no good to us if you're dead. And don't let that thing step on you. The Pride is on me. The goal. But we can't get into the facility with those energy fields up. Rothschild and Lee say this robot should be able to take down the energy fields. So we're on fire support. We stay close to the thing, keep it clear, and get it to where it needs to go. Once the fields are down, we head straight for the facility.
Yeah? I hope you brought me some cool stuff.
We'll use the robot to keep them occupied while we get inside and secure the control room. We need to move quickly before we lose the chance to surprise them. Get whatever supplies you don't already have, and we'll meet in the Bailey. When we're done with this, everyone can have a nice cold glass of water on me. Let's move. All right, Rothschild, fire it up. Pry, move out! Make it to the purifier, we can chat then. Now's not exactly a good time.
Titanium alloy supplemented by photonic resonance barrier. Vulnerability of mission entrance. Communist detected on American soil. Lethal force engaged. Communism is a temporary setback on the road to freedom. Thank you. democracy is truth. Communism is death. We will not fear the red menace. Democracy is non-negotiable.
you again. I can't say I'm surprised. You and your ilk seem hell-bent on destroying everything our government has worked to achieve. There's nothing to stop me from killing you this time. Let's end this. You're in over your head, I'm afraid. But this is the path you choose for yourself. Tell your father I said hello.
And so it was that the Lone Wanderer ventured forth from Vault 101, intent on discovering the fate of a father who had once sacrificed the future of humanity for that of his only child. The Capital Wasteland proved a cruel, inhospitable place, but the Lone Wanderer refused to surrender to the vices that had claimed so many others. The values passed on from father to child: selflessness, compassion, honor, guided this noble soul through countless trials and triumphs. But it was not until the end of this long road that the Lone Wanderer learned the true meaning of that greatest of virtues, sacrifice. Stepping into the irradiated control chamber of Project Purity, the child followed the example of the father, sacrificing life itself for the greater good of mankind. Thankfully, when selected by the sinister president to be his instrument of annihilation, the Wanderer refused. Humanity, with all its flaws, was deemed worthy of preservation. The waters of life flowed at last, free and pure for any and all. The Capital Wasteland, at long last, was saved. So ends the story of the Lone Wanderer, who stepped through the great door of Vault 101 and into the annals of legend. But the tale of humanity will never come to a close, for the struggle of survival is a war without end. And war never changes.
Like that?
You're reporting to Sarah from here on out. Don't let her down. She's right here. Unresponsive, but stable. To see that you've recovered gives me hope. As you know, I had my reservations about engaging the Enclave. They did not directly attack us, and I believed we had time. Time to be cautious. Their assault on the Purifier forced our hand. We had no choice but to engage them directly. And once that engagement was begun, we could do nothing but see it through to the end. If they had not considered us a threat before, they do now. So we have spent the time since you and I last spoke, systematically locating and destroying every bastion of Enclave force we can. Liberty Prime has proven far more successful than any of us could have hoped for. The Brotherhood has taken over control of the Purifier and is managing distribution of the water to the people of the Wasteland. If you travel there, speak with Scribe Bigsley. He's heading up the on-site operation. Please be careful. I would hate to lose you again.